I made 75 3D models in just 50 days using only Blender and a free photo editing tool called Photopea. Obviously it's not the most professional one, but it can do its job really well. At the beginning of this challenge, I had 25 3D models at my website, sliceblue3d.com. 25 is not a big number, so I wanted it to be 100. 100 3D models are pretty decent, and I decided to give it a shot. At that time, I was creating one or two 3D models a week, but I was sure I could do more. I convinced myself that I was able to create more than one model a day, and I created a plan. Initially, I gave myself a 60-day limit, but I wanted it to be more challenging, motivating, and rewarding. So I gave myself 50 days to complete the challenge. The first 2 days, I decided to gather references, all 75 of them, and things went pretty well. I had every reference I needed, and I even managed to create this nice looking computer mouse. It was day 3 when the real work began. For the next 25 days, my plan was to create all 75 3D models without materials. That is about 3 models per day. But things didn't go so smoothly. Day 3, I already had made one 3D model, and I was only 2 models away from the plan. But I failed. I only managed to create one more model. Day 4 was promising because I made 3 more models. Day 5 was not good. I only managed to create 2. And then day 6, I didn't do anything. After that, I was slowly getting closer to the plan. 3 more models, 5 more, 2 more. 4 more, 3 more, 5 more, and then day 13, I didn't do anything again. Day 14 was okay, day 15, nothing. Day 16 was okay, day 17, nothing. After that, I decided that day 17 was the last day of nothing. And then day 18, oh my. It was the most productive day of all. I made 8 more 3D models. I continued to do more and more until day 26, when I did nothing again. And the next day was the day, according to the plan, that I should have made 75 3D models. But instead, I had made only 65. 10 more to go. I just pushed myself harder, and I was 2 days late, but ultimately I created 75 3D models, and then it was the phase of UV unwrapping. The plan was to unwrap these models in 5 days, but I was 2 days late modeling, so I had only 3 days left. I really tried to squeeze into these 3 days, but I couldn't. Instead, I was able to do the job in 5 days. And now the last phase of this challenge is, of course, texturing, which was very tough. At this point of time, I was kinda tired constantly working on this project for the last 34 days. This can probably explain a huge 4-day gap of nothing, but I was not giving up. Instead, I became so efficient that I reached maximum speed of 20 models per day. That was at the last day of this challenge. And in the end, I had made 62 models out of 75. The rest 13 of them were finished the following day. Well, technically I failed this challenge because of that one extra day, but I still feel successful. It was a great experience after all. I did 3 times more in just 50 days than I had done in more than a year. Of course, I still have to bake textures and upload the models to my website. But if you are watching this in the future, chances are you can already download them from sliceblue3d.com. Like and subscribe.